There's a hole in the ceiling of this crypt. I think I might be able to squeeze through. Wow, it's a tunnel that opens on a deep, dark forest. It looks familiar somehow.
Oh, gold. Hang on a sec. So if I... and look through the portal? Portal?
Oh, there's nothing like family.
No matter what may happen
in the topsy-turvy world of the Caribbean resort business, gold. I can always relax in the knowledge that I come from good, wealthy stock. Breeding. That's what's important. Breeding and culture. Just
yes.
Like Grandfather Lambert. Breeding, culture, and lots of red.
Grandfather might look a little bit different all of a sudden.
It makes a man proud. It's funny. I don't remember Grandfather Lambert as looking so... so common. Oh, weird. It's like his eyes follow me. Pictures like that really creep me out.
Oh, my God. That puzzle. Oh, jeez. That was pretty stupid. So now if I go and actually talk to him, will he think he look... Oh, yes, I know. So if we talk to him and he can see some family resemblance, then I do the pretend to die thing again. And I'll end up in What's Her Face's
tomb. Look at me. Don't I look just like a good soup?
Now that you mention it, you do bear a slight resemblance to my great-grandfather, C. Lambert Goodsoup.
Yeah.
Clammy? Why, folks back home used to tell me all the time. You're the spitting image of old Chowder Goodsoup.
You know, I think you're right. I wonder why I didn't see it before.
I don't know. Weird. I could just talk about the Goodsoup history all day.
I could just talk about Goodsoup history all day.
I just happen to have a book
about
of it.
About that first fateful journey made to the Caribbean?
Oh, you mean the one that... Baron Salmon Bisque de Goodsoup began in 1621?
Exactly. He landed on Scab Island.
Scab Island.
With just a spoon and a dream. In just 4 short years, he had formed the largest chain of all soup restaurants in the Western Hemisphere. By 1635, he had driven the entire Van Salid family out of the Caribbean and had a restaurant empire that spanned the globe.
Actually, the Van Salids were not driven out until 1637, and the Goodsoup chain of restaurants and resorts never did become popular in the South Pacific.
Yes, we are. All right. Whatever. Well, son, it looks like you were right. Welcome back to the glorious name of Goodsoup.
I'm, honored.
And as a Goodsoup, you're welcome to every benefit the name provides. Instant prestige around Blood Island.
Nice.
A 10% discount at any of the Goodsoup resorts in the Caribbean.
Ooh.
And, of course, medical, dental, and a 401k. Best thing of all, if you should happen to drop dead, you will be buried in the extravagant Goodsoup family crypt.
It's as if all my dreams have come true.
Yes. So how about a drink? I'll have a drink,
please.
Sure, sure.
And we'll stick some of that in it. And nick it.
Dear, he's had a sudden and completely unexpected relapse of death. Oh, and just as we were getting reacquainted.
Yeah.
As his kinsman, it is my duty to give him a proper burial. It is my solemn vow. Young, hearty beef and potato shall be buried in the Goodsoup family crypt.
All right.
Oh, this is a little bit fancier.
Ominous. I had a hard enough time getting out of it.
Nah.
Yeah, all right. Crumbling hole.
Hey, there's a hole in the ceiling of this crypt. I think I might be able to squeeze through.
Yeah. Oh.
Wow, it's a tunnel that opens on a deep, dark forest. It looks familiar somehow. As if I've seen it in a dream. Or maybe it's... I don't know.
Great jumping monkeys! A terrifying horde of stunningly rendered rabid jaguars! They're coming right at me!
It's a good thing I couldn't get through that hole. I'd be done for.
Oh, that was brilliant. What else we got? We got a plaque.
It's a memorial plaque for Mini Strony Goodsoup.
Are you gonna read it?
Nah. It's a memorial plaque for Mini Strony Goodsoup.
What's it say, though?
No.
Oh.
Yikes.
El ghosty. Hello?
It's a ghost in a bride's gown. She looks very sad and lonely.
Oh.
Oh, hello there.
Who are you
and what are you doing here?
I am Minnie Goodsoup, last in a long line of eligible Goodsoup debutantes. I was buried here exactly 1 week after my wedding day.
Oh.
A wedding day that never came.
Oh.
What happened?
I was the Belle of Blood Island.
How many people can claim that?
Oh, how the lads adored me. I was courted by the richest, most handsome men in the Caribbean. But all my suitors bored me to tears. I wanted someone dangerous. I wanted a pirate. By the way, what do you do for a living?
Flooring inspector.
Oh. Then one day, a real pirate sailed his ship into the bay. I fell for him instantly, and we became engaged.
It wasn't LeChuck, was it?
But he left me standing at the altar, and I died of a broken heart.
Wow. That bites.
Oh, I know.
Were there any other suitors you found attractive?
Well, there was one I could have fallen for. Young Charles de Goulash. He had such a radiant smile.
What happened to him?
You know, it's funny. I don't know. He checked into the hotel one night and I never saw him again.
His spirit might be around somewhere.
What happened to that young man you liked so much?
Why, the last time I saw Charles,
oh, sorry.
He had checked into the hotel.
Go into the light.
If only it were that easy. I'm afraid I can never leave this crypt until I marry. Are you attached?
Actually, yes.
Engaged, actually.
Oh, what a shame. You sure have pretty eyes.
Oh.
And I'm a mighty pirate.
Hey, nice ring.
Uh-oh.
Was it something I said?
I hate this ring. It's been passed down from mother to daughter in the Goodsoup family for generations. It was to be my wedding ring until that evil pirate stole the diamond and left me. Left me here to die of a broken heart.
Where's the diamond for your ring?
It's gone. He took it.
Who took it?
My love. My honey cakes. My widow schnoobums. My LeChuck.
LeChuck is your schnoobums?
He pried the diamond from its satin during the rehearsal dinner. Oh, what a fool I was. He told me he was taking it out to get some fresh air.
Where did LeChuck take the diamond?
Cad! The fiend! He sold it to the smugglers of Skull Island! It's just so humiliating! I could just die!
Right, so that's... So we need to get to Skull Island for the rest of the diamond.
Since you're, not using it, can I have your engagement band?
This ring will remain on my finger until I have a wedding band to replace it.
Right, so we need to find that ghost of the guy who died in the bed.
How do I get out of this crypt?
There's no way out of this crypt for either of us. I must haunt this lonely tomb until I've married a man I truly love. And you can't leave because the door's locked.
This is just a shade too creepy for me. I'm leaving.
Anything? Oh, what's this way? What's that? A crowbar?
It's a universal crowbar.
What was that?
It's a universal crowbar.
This is going to be so cool.
What? Who?
Good soup is food.
Food is good soup. Who's giggling?
Going to do that again. I think I broke my skull. I'm all skull.
It's your own fault. Stop scaring me like that.
So I did scare you? Really?
Well, startled is more like it.
Oh.
but startled in a terrified kind of way. You really are very, very scary.
Don't talk down to me.
I really don't have any choice.
I saw you get out of that crypt. Does this mean that you're dead?
No, I was only faking.
Darn, I thought together we could walk among the living and spawn a new wave of terror throughout the Caribbean.
So what you're saying is that you only love me for my legs.
Something like that.
All right, Murray, how are you doing?
It's Murray. Hi, Murray.
Oh, it hurts.
How did you get here anyway? Can we pick it up now? Ooh. Murray!
You just can't stop jammering. I don't want to get caught up in a conversation with Murray right now.
Aww. Where's Murray? Coffin lid. What's in there?
Nice coffin lid. No.
It's okay. Can I use the crowbar on the rest of the coffin?
I can't use the crowbar with that.
Family crest.
I can't use the crowbar with that.
Ah. Oh. Look through crack. Yeah. Was he the guy much earlier on who, when I took a pin out of a voodoo doll, he was affected? Was that this guy? Was that dinosaur?
It's a dinosaur from the monsters that time couldn't care less about.
Poster.
It's a poster for some dumb book about undead pirates.
Werewolf.
Spooky.
Mort's
novel. It looks like he's writing a horror novel. It's called The Grog That Drank People. Part one of a three-book cycle.
Bloody hell.
I wonder why trashy media always comes in threes. It's a glowing lantern.
Posters.
It's the poster for some really trashy monster book. Trust me, it'll never sell.
What does that say? Moby Dick. The Sickers? The Breaking? Can't quite read that. Sickers.
It's a poster for Suckers 12.
Suckers.
The Beaking.
The Beaking. Your parrot's dead.
It's either a dead parrot or a very strange bat.
A raven?
It's the stuff that really boring dreams are made of.
A LeChuck mask.
Looks like a Halloween mask.
Is it not going to be a mask and it's going to be...
It's a bunch of cheesy horror stories.
Hanged smuggle bunny.
Cloying, yet grisly at the same time. That must be the gravedigger.
Can I talk to him?
Hey, mister! Help!
What? Who's there? Who said that? Who's scaring poor old Mort, the gravedigger?
There's been a horrifying mistake. I've been buried alive in the Goodsoup family crypt.
All right. This joke has gone far enough. You kids should be ashamed of yourselves.
It's no joke. I'm really trapped in here.
Crazy kids with your long hair and your Baroque music. Fool me once, shame on you. Fool me twice, shame on me.
This isn't a trick. I'm really trapped in this crypt. I drank a special potion that put me into a coma. Thinking I was dead, they buried me in this crypt.
Yeah, right. They did that in the book. Never trade lunches with a corpse. If you kids ever came up with an original idea, I might believe you.
Just come and look at me through this crack.
Oh, sure. I turn my back to the door and you thieving little hoodlums will sneak up from behind and tie me up. I read all about your sinister ways in my horror novels, so nothing doing.
You must love horror stories to own all these collectibles.
Reading fantastic stories about the dead helps me keep my mind off my work.
Why are you wasting your money on all this bad fiction?
At least my bad fiction doesn't require over $1,000 in hardware.
I see your point.
Ooh.
Let me out of this crypt!
I'm not falling for your tricks this time. Just leave me alone and let me read my horror novels.
Curses, you've seen through my web of deceit. I'm no ordinary man trapped in a crypt.
Well, what are you then?
My fast and light ship is trapped in subspace anomaly. I seek the golden rods of Cthon to bring peace to the Shire. I am an angry and deranged ghost haunting this crypt. I'm selling these fine leather jackets.
My faster than light ship is trapped in a subspace anomaly.
You have no ship. Any true warp traveler would know that reversing the polarity of the ion flux field would result in a tachyon expansion wave, creating a trail of neutrinos that could be followed out of the anomaly.
What I meant to say was...
Damn you, he knows too much.
I seek the golden rods of Cthon to bring peace to the Shire.
Do you bear the mark of Tixplick, the chosen one foretold by the scrolls of the Third Shadow?
I was hoping you wouldn't ask. What I meant to say was... I'm selling these fine leather jackets.
I'm a vegan. I hate the exploitation of animals.
Really? But what about all those stuffed heads on your wall?
Oh, only one of those is real.
Actually, I'm a ghost trapped in this crypt.
Then let me see you appear before me.
Excuse me?
If you were a real spirit, you could materialize in a ghostly form. It's all in the books. Well, let's see it.
Isn't the ominous sound of my disembodied voice proof enough? I guess not. Fear me. I'm an evil ghost.
Then go ahead. Show your ghastly visage.
I can't. I'm shy.
You're no ghost.
All right, we need something else.
I'm gonna go sulk in the darkness now.
Have a good time.
You said only one of these is real.
It's hard to see what it is from where I'm standing. Judging by the beard, I'm guessing it's a goat.
How did you read these posters, then? Mort, LeChuck, Raven, Parrot. Oh, now can I use this? Come on something like...
I've got it.
Hey, what happened to the light?
Let's have a look at the lantern. Oh, no. Nope.
It's a glowing lantern.
Can I use that on Murray? Oh!
Murray, do your stuff.
Okay.
Mortal fool, release me from this wretched tomb. I must be set free, or I will haunt you forever. I will hide your keys beneath the cushions of your upholstered furniture. And never more will you be able to find socks that match.
All right, hang on. I'm coming.
Great work, Murray.
I was terrifying, wasn't I? My demonic powers have made me omnipotent!
Uh-oh. Looks like the lantern ran out of oil.
There. It's open. Now shuffle off and give me peace.
Oh, hurry up. I'll be back there. I need to find you a husband. There it is. Open door. Open door policy in this crypt. Ah, Stan. You've done it. You actually done it.
Mutual of Stan.
Hey, Guybrush. There sure are a lot of skeletons in here.
Uh-oh.
Quick, pull the head off one and stick me on top of the spine!
I don't think I want you walking around freely, Murray.
Oh, please!
I'm getting out of here.
What?
Well, Murray, are you ready to continue our heady adventuring? Murray? Where'd he go?
Oh, no, we lost Murray. Aww. Let's get some water.
Pirates don't drink purified water.
Hey, Stan. How's business, Stan? What? Have we missed a conversation?
You've convinced me. I want to buy some insurance.
A wise choice, and one you won't soon regret. The question isn't whether or not you can afford to buy an insurance policy. It's whether you can afford not to. Speaking of which, can you afford to buy an insurance policy?
Well, how much does it cost?
Oh, that depends on a variety of factors. How much coverage you need, how much you're willing to spend, all sorts of highly complicated sliding scale insurance equations and such. But I won't bore you with all that. Just let me ask you this. How much money do you have?
Well, I've got these wooden nickels.
I see. Maybe I've confused you somewhere along the line. While nothing would please me more to send you out of here, with the peace of mind that your family will be provided for in the unlikely event of your death, I have to run a business here. If you can't at least show me some collateral, I can't give you a policy.
This antique handcrafted bottle of rich, creamy shaving soap. The closest, most comfortable shave possible.
Not interested.
This one-of-a-kind Big Whoop refrigerator magnet. Very collectible.
Surely you're joking.
This fine cane-handled umbrella. Makes a great gift.
No.
This attractive mallet and chisel combination set. Use them separately or as a pair?
I don't think so.
An assortment of tarot cards. Practice the mystic art of fortune-telling at home or on vacation.
I've only got one, haven't I?
I don't think so.
Rare first edition volume of the Goodsoup family history. Very valuable, very educational.
I don't think so.
A genuine, high-quality die-cast stainless steel crowbar. Great for those embarrassing live burials.
Not interested.
This highly accurate map to Blood Island.
Yeah.
I absolutely guarantee you won't find another one just like it.
Not interested.
This authentic pirate relic. A genuine tooth from an actual pirate. Only one of its kind.
Is that real gold?
Oh.
The finest known to man. Not much spit on it either anymore.
Yeah.
Now you're starting to speak my language. All right, let's find a coverage plan that suits your needs. And you can rest assured that you've provided for your family well after your unfortunate departure.
What are the terms of this plan exactly?
It's quite simple, son. When you die, whoever holds that policy gets a lot of money.
A lot of money? Wow.
Ooh.
Wow is right. Now I want you to be careful out there.
Okay, I will. Thanks.
No, I'm serious. I want you to be very, very careful.
Will do. The coffin lid desk is a nice touch. File cabinets. What is it about these things that makes them so popular in office settings? No.
Aw.
Nah.
Banker's lamp.
A sure sign of a fine, classy business establishment.
Really? All right, let's have a look.
This entitles the bearer of this document to the sum of a lot of money. On the event of the demise of Hearty Beef and Potato Good Soup.
Okay. So how do I...
Hey, what an amazing story I have to tell. I was dead, but I live again. Who wants to hear about it? You guys don't deserve to hear a good story.
So what was in... there it is. I was going to say, what was these filing cabinets?
This hereby certifies that Hearty Beef and Potato Good Soup met his demise at least once on Blood Island.
Gimme. And let's give this to Stan.
Welcome back to Mutual of Stan.
Yes, I have a death certificate for you.
I'm cashing in this insurance policy. Give me a lot of money.
But this is a life insurance policy. You collect when the policyholder dies.
No, honest. I was dead for a really long time.
And you just got better?
Well, yes.
Do you have any proof of this miracle?
As a matter of fact, smart guy, I've got your proof right here. A death certificate.
Well, this must be some kind of mistake.
It's right there in high-res black and white. I died. Give me a lot of money.
It looks like I'm left with no choice but to acquiesce.
No, just give me my money.
That's what I mean.
Oh, thanks.
Ooh. How much money did I get? Insurance money.
This is a lot of money.
Alright, how quick before I lose all this money? Somebody keel hauls me over a bridge or something like that. Yeah, well, we cashed in on our own death that we faked. I don't know if that is an offense in this island or not, but I guess we'll see.